Good morning, everyone. We are continuing here in the Orchis Yosher, in the world of tefillah, of prayer. And the Rav Chaim Kanievsky begins a new topic in the world of prayer today, and that is the prohibition against speaking idle talk during prayer and in shul. Speaking devarim betelim, idle conversations, inconsequential words, im eina tzarche mitzvah, if it's not for the sake of doing a mitzvah, who iser gamar, it is a complete breach. It is a iser gamar, it is a total prohibition to do such a thing. It says in the Shulchan Aruch, v'ayin sham v'mishnah brura, it says, shehichmir ma'ayid b'zeh. It's very, very stringent over there in regards to speaking extraneous words. U'befrat b'shas ha'tfilah v'chazar ha'shat, certainly to speak at the time that people are davening, or the repetition of the Shmoneh Esrei, the Issa b'Shulchan Aruch, there it says, the gadol avayna minasai, which means that the sin is too heavy to bear. And the Shulchan Aruch does not write these words very often, might never write them besides over here, the sin of talking in the midst of tefillah, in the midst of prayer, or of the repetition of the Shmoneh Esrei, the sin is too great to bear. Ukriyas haTorah v'Kaddish, so too when they're reading the Torah, or someone is saying Kaddish, or Mekaymish and Mevarim b'Shulchan Aruch she'asa b'divo, any other place where it says in the Shulchan Aruch that a person should not speak, she'in shum heter b'zeh, there is no leniency. It is not permitted at all to speak during these times. V'chalila l'zalzel b'zeh, God forbid, says Rav Chaim Kanievsky, that a person should disgrace these areas of tefillah and talk during them. Mishum shahar me'anoshim mezalzim b'zeh, unfortunately many, many people do make light of it, and they don't take it seriously, and they're very lax when it comes to this. Ki af he masidim liten esadin, in the future you should know that you're going to have to give a din v'cheshbon, you'll have to give an accounting. Every single time that you spoke in shul in a place that you weren't allowed to during davening, HaKadosh Baruch Hu is marking it all down in his book. And after 120 years, we're going to go up to Shemayim and he's going to pull out a long list. And we're going to see all these conversations. And Hashem's going to say, why did you have this conversation? I said, well, I was talking, I was schmoozing. And he's going to say, no, the issue is, I don't have a problem with you schmoozing, even if you speak Devarim Betelim, inconsequential words. It's not a good habit for anyone to be in on a regular basis, but sometimes you need a good schmooze. But in shul, during davening, during chazar sashatz, during the laning, the balkar is up there, he's reading the parsha shavua, which is to infuse us with the proper outlook on life, to keep us connected to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, and you're in the back talking about whatever deal you made this week, you're in the back talking about the bar mitzvah that's coming up, the chasana, what's for kiddush, all the different things that we find ourselves talking about. How could a person do such a thing? Says Rav Chaim Kanievsky, whoever is mezalzel, whoever ends up being lax in these areas, they will have to give a din v'cheshbon at the end of the day, meaning at the end of 120 years, they'll be obligated to explain to HaKadosh Baruch Hu why they had all these conversations. V'omru v'meseches derech eretz. The sages teach us, Rabbi Chama bar Chanina Ashkach le'Eliyahu. Rabbi Chama met up with Eliyahu HaNavi. V'ime gemalim te'unim. And Eliyahu had many camels that were loaded up with wares or with burdens. Amalei, so Rabbi Chama said, Ma gemalim alal ta'unim, what are these camels carrying? So Amalei, so Eliyahu Novi said, Af v'reges, they're carrying wrath and anger. L'misha mesaper ben kedusha l'kedusha, to a person who spoke in the middle of kedusha, ben kedusha l'baruch, to the person who spoke between kedusha and baruch, ben yehesh mei rabba l'yisbaruch, and whoever spoke between yehesh mei rabba and yisbaruch, or ben kol bracha bracha, anyone who spoke between any of the blessings in shul, these camels are loaded up with wrath and anger against them. V'chol ha'medaber behem, anyone who speaks during these times when they're not supposed to, Allah akasav oimev alayisi karasa Yaakov. So the pasuk says in that case, you did not call out to me, O Yaakov, because you had a chance to call out to me in prayer. You're standing in the base, like, you already went through the trouble. You got out of bed, you got yourself dressed, you got in the car, you slept all the way to Shul. If it's Shabbos, you walked 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 20 minutes, a half an hour there, in the sun, in the rain, in the cold, in the wind, in the heat. You got to Shul. You walked all the way into the Shul. You're wrapped in your talis and your tefillin or your talis on Shabbos. You're there already. The davening is going on. You're ready to bask in the glory of this tremendous mitzvah of tefillah, of prayer. Instead, what do? You end up schmoozing away. Dvarim betalim, words that have no consequence in the Beis HaMidrash, in the Beis HaKnesses, that don't belong in our tefillahs. And then says the Pasuk, you're there, your lips are moving, you're davening. However, like Karasi Yaakov, you didn't call out to me, O Yaakov, Klal Yisrael, because you were busy defaming the words of prayer by schmoozing idly in the Beis HaKnesses in the Shul when you're not supposed to. This is just the beginning, and we have to be so careful with what we say in the shul. It should be words of Torah, of tefillah, and dvarim, and those things that are for the sake of a mitzvah that we're allowed to. All the other things, it seems to be, are going to be words that should be left outside the doors of our Beis HaKnesses, of our shuls. Have a wonderful, wonderful day.